Hello, beautiful people. Just going to give you a little taste today of what Sonia and I are planning. This is Sonia Weyrich. Welcome.
Oh, yeah, so nice to be here, Brenda. Thanks for inviting me.
Sonia's just arrived for her massage, so we're going to just not take up too much of time of her bodywork session and give you a little taste of what we're going to be doing in the next few weeks with videos to help boost your immune system through calming your nervous system. Staying calm is really important at this time, especially with the panic around coronavirus and everything that's going on. And so we really need to focus on our nervous systems as a tool, a pathway to keeping our bodies healthy and to strengthening our immunity. So Sonia, tell me a little bit about what you do. You've done so much. You've got so much wisdom to share with us. How did you come to all this wisdom?
Well, thank you, Brenda. So I've been teaching yoga since 2007. My mother, though, throughout growing up, she always did yoga. And I've come to yoga because it always gave me a peace in mind, body, and spirit. And I loved that it wasn't just a physical practice, but it connected to me to what's much greater than myself. And that's mm-hmm. where I found the most peace in that connection with what's beyond my physical body, my physical experience. And that's why I've always kept up with the practice of yoga. And in that, deepening the physical practice, but more so deepening that connection to what is greater than ourselves or our that part of us that is beyond the physical.
Right, because we are more than our physical bodies.
Yes.
And yet, we need to stay so connected to our physical bodies because we're on Earth, right? And we're in this Earth plane, we're in these what we call Earth suits,
yes.
And we need to really take care of them. And the nervous system is part of that.
Mm-hmm.
So how does your practice specifically engage the nervous system to get into that parasympathetic state, which is the state of relaxation?
So I, like you say, that we are a physical body, and there's, you know, a great saying that you've probably heard is the body is a temple. And to treat the body as a temple to host our spirit. And yoga is such a beautiful practice that caters to caring for the body and the breath. One practice that is just very powerful is always coming back to the breath. The breath is always in the present moment. And the breath can, it's one of the quickest tools to engage to downshift or draw, calm down the nervous system simply by paying attention to the breath. And the breath links. Very good, Brenda.
Just reminding me.
Yes. And the breath links mind, body, and spirit. So it also helps to facilitate this connection of wholeness. Would you like to do a quick practice?
Yes, let's do that. This is some of what we'll be sharing with you over the next couple of weeks.
So one very simple thing that you can do during your day is just pause for a moment, place your hands on your belly, and this helps to draw the breath down to use the diaphragm. When we breathe with the neck and shoulders, that engages the stress response. So if you notice you're breathing like this, then you're just agitating yourself more and more. So
I'm almost actually getting a little dizzy when I try that out.
Yes.
For a few breaths, and it's so shallow that it kind of ends here, and my head starts to get lightheaded.
Yes.
It's almost like I'm going to hyperventilate,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that hyperventilation is a part of the stress response.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so one of the quickest ways is to shift out of that pattern is to just place your hands on your belly, and that just that sensory input takes your awareness to your belly. And that will help you to begin to breathe into your hands. So you can take an inhale into your hands and allow the hands just to soften on the exhale. And doing that very calmly, very quietly, very smoothly will begin to calm the nervous system. And the quieter the breath becomes, the mind follows. So the mind begins to quiet as the breath begins to quiet. And you tune more into the sensation of the breath moving underneath your hands. And additionally, you can begin to lengthen your exhale. So making your exhale a little bit longer than your inhale. And that further engages that relaxation response. And I can see in your face it's having such a beautiful impact. The face softens, the eyes soften. You can just notice in Brenda right now how that has totally changed her whole disposition. Her whole energy is just shifted as she takes that calming breath. It's a beautiful demonstration to see it happen right here.
It was happening. But absolutely, it makes sense if you're really in it and really present with it and allow yourself to feel into the breath and then allow the breath to breathe you rather than forcing the breath in and out. I think that's the key, right?
Yes.
Is to allow the breath to do its work.
Yes.
And allow your mind to focus on the breath. Then that's when we connect and everything comes into alignment. And then I can feel my parasympathetic nervous system, like making that shifting gears from being quite like excited about having you here and you know that energy to I think now I'll speak calmer, slower, deeper.
And that's what I notice in your body work is you engage the breath and then we begin to, as the recipient, we begin to connect to that rhythm and we let go of control and allow the body to take over. Like I see that in the body work that you do with me, where you facilitate. Can you talk more about that?
Sure, yes. The kahuna body work that I practice is very breath-centered. It comes from Hawaii, and Hawaii obviously is around breath. Ha is the breath of life. And we call the dance, we call it a dance, the dance of breath and life from the heart. And so the breath is really the central focus of the massage, as well as the flowing movements that flow up and down the body, which do all the things that massage do, but with a lot more greater sense of flow. And the breath obviously is our connection to flow, isn't it? It's like it flows in and it flows out, just like the waves breaking on the shore, the ocean. And so that's the sense that comes into the bodywork practice. And getting a client or a person on the bed to become aware of their breath and imagine it like the ocean flowing in and out, just doing that. I can hear you breathing differently. Mm-hmm. I can hear you taking different breaths. And you're also softening. Mm-hmm. This is just magical. We didn't plan this. Mm-hmm. You know, I can see you softening and your gaze is softening. And so that's how we work with the nervous system during the massage, with the breath being a really imperative part of it.
If someone can't come in for a massage, is there something that you recommend where they can kind of take in the tools of kahuna?
Yeah,
and apply it to themselves.
There's so much that I can share, and it's very much a mind-body practice as well. So it's about bringing the mind into the present moment, manava, making it present, and what you focus on expands. So if we're focusing on the breath will expand, and as we expand the breath, we then get more calm, right? Mm-hmm. So I often also I did a yoga class with Sonia this morning online. She's also experimenting with doing online courses and classes of her breath-centered Vinyasa yoga that she teaches. And we did it on Zoom this morning for the first time. And it was really amazing how we could all actually connect in real time rather than just watching a video online in my own time, because that's very isolating. You know, you can get up and go and do whatever you like, but there was Sonia watching us all on Zoom to do it, making sure we did it, and we felt like part of a group. It was amazing how it worked.
It was really interesting. I didn't know how it would work, but you still had that personal connection though it was through the screen. Like we had that relationship. It was different than being in person. Sure. But it was still we're all working together, and it was quite interesting.
It was. So my point about the yoga class was that we did the breathing, which we often do in a yoga class, is to breathe into the belly, like we've just done now, and to feel the rise and fall of the belly to engage the diaphragm. But often we then get to leave out the chest, and when we're not engaging the chest and the rib cage, where all these muscles here, which are our breathing muscles and connected to the diaphragm, are not working, when we go into a state of fear and contraction, everything shuts down, including the breath, but also these muscles all tighten and come in. So in the body work that I do, and it's actually not if you're not here for the body work, that's okay. What we need to focus on is expanding, right? Mm-hmm. So opening up the breath from the heart center and the belly so that you're getting the diaphragm, which is right in that central place underneath the breastbone.
Yes.
So when you actually connect to the diaphragm, and with kahuna massage, the one form of breath that we have as breath practice is called pico pico breathing. So pico means
I love the name, pico pico.
So it's from, you know, from center to center, and we see the belly button, the navel as the center, and the crown as a center of energy. And so you literally just breathe from your awareness. So you can put your hands there now just to feel it, and then bring your hands back down to a natural relaxed position. And now just breathe, bringing your awareness to the crown of your head. Just breathing, and so in your mind's eye, feeling your breath go up as you breathe in, draw your breath up to the crown of your head. And as you exhale, take your breath down to your belly button. And then bringing it up to the head and down again to the belly button. So very slowly, the slower you do it, the more you go into parasympathetic state.
I feel my shoulders dropping.
And then down to the belly button. And as long and as slow as your breath can go, keeping it flowing. And it might be that you can actually get a deeper breath eventually. Mm-hmm. I just heard Sonia do a deeper breath in, a longer breath. And so just breathing in and then making sure that the breath is traveling all the way up through the rib cage to the head. And then all the way down back to the belly. So we do this a few times, and there's more to this practice, which I can share at a later stage, but that's a good place to start.
I could stay here for forever.
Okay, she's going into massage stage. We're going to get her on the massage table now and give her session. Yes. And we're going to see you again very soon. Yes. We'll be speaking on Zoom again on Saturday, and we'll send you all the recording. If you would like to stay in touch and keep up to date with the recordings, you can sign up for our newsletters on my website. Where do they sign up for a newsletter from you?
You can, I don't have a newsletter set up yet, but you can email me if you have any questions. You can email Brenda as well if you have questions you'd like us to specifically address.
Absolutely. And so we'll put all those details in a link below this video. This is now going to be on YouTube. And so I think we're fiddling and finding our way, right, with technology. We all have to make very quick learning
adjustments
and very quick steep learning curves to get used to technology so that we can share our information and continue to share and collaborate information with each other. We'll even be getting other, you know, wellness experts and chatting to them about how to calm the nervous system and why we need to, right? Mm-hmm. So look at the link below. There's our email addresses and our newsletter links and website links, and you can get hold of us and just subscribe so that you can stay in touch. We look forward to sharing a little bit more just to help us all on this very strange journey that we're on right now.
Thank you so much, Brenda. Thank you all.